Today is Saturday, 5th of March 2016. This munchkin, Persian kitten, about 9 months, right?
Yeah.
9 months, was purchased by the owner 1 month ago, and the groomer says that this cat had very dirty ears, which we checked yesterday. It's full of dirt. And the groomer has cleaned about maybe 80%. It's still very deep in. The dirt is still there now. The other complaint about this kitten is actually the eyes, tearing of the eyes. So one of the important tests should be this fluorescein stain test, which when in contact with corneal ulcer would change to green in color. So we have to check whether the cat has corneal ulcer by using this stain. So although we can see that there is no ulcer superficially without the stain, but now we have put the stain and we can see that the cornea is not stained green. It's not stained green. So we can confirm that the tearing is not due to the let me open the eyes. The tearing is not due to the ulcer. I think you see the eye open already. So we check that the tearing is not due to corneal ulcers. Okay. Now when the owner bought this kitten, the tearing was already there. Now one reason could be, of course, the dirty ears. When the ears are dirty, the kitten scratches the ear and then the eyes get rubbed as well. So that is one reason. The other reason is, of course, is an infection of the eyes, eyelids, conjunctivitis, and that can cause tearing. The third reason would be, of course, is born with this blocked tear duct. So the tears can't flow out through the nose, so it flows into the overflow into the eyelids. That is due to blocked tear duct. Then the other one, of course, is due to the entropium, which is the inrolling of the eyelids, or something affected the irritating the eyes, the cornea. So these are the possible reasons. So now put it here first. Put the kitten here first. Then I will just let it open the eyes naturally, and we just see there looks to be no ulcers at all. Yeah, okay, it doesn't like the bright lights because of the light. So we confirm that there is no ulcer. Okay, then look at the nose. The nose, is there any running nose or not? Because it could be cat flu, the virus infection. Okay, seems to be a bit of running nose on the left side. Now, normally when you use the fluorescent stain, it will come out through the nose if the tear duct is not blocked. Now you don't see any of the orange stuff coming out from the nose nostril. So this one way to confirm that the nasal lacrimal duct is blocked. It's blocked, so there isn't any orange stuff coming out. You hold the neck. Let me just see any orange. Orange dye coming through now. This seems to be. Let me see. Focus on it. Let me study the video again. Okay. So nothing.
Oh, what's wrong with the eyes?
So now I have examined it, and we would give the ear cleaning, and then clean up the eyes, and I check further under a bit of gas because this kitten is not very happy. But you can see that the nostril definitely has some discharge from probably from a old flu earlier on. The owner has bought it for 1 month, and it was the ears were very dirty at that time, so that would be the main complaint.
Thank you.
Don't know how to clear the ears, irrigate the ears.
The eyes.
The eyes, yeah, we'll check the eyes, yeah. No, I just checked, there's no ulcer. And it's a block. It's a block, tear duct. That's why there's no orange stain from the nose. Otherwise, in other cases, the orange dye will come out through the nose when the tear duct is not blocked. This will explain to the owners. But you need to do the test, because if the vet doesn't do the test, and just have an examination, then he will know. You see, he will know that there is cornea ulcer or not, or blocked tear duct. Okay, so March 62016. Stop by your vets.